Completing the driving check.
Je te jure, je te jure, il a fui avec mon appareil de
No problem. Hello. It's okay. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil mursaleen.
Allahumma salli wa sallim.
Sayyidina wa nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi. الطاهرين المطهرين أفضل الرضوان والصلاة على نبينا المصطفى وأفضل الرضوان على صحابته الكرام أما بعد فنقول أمام حضرات هذه الأئمة الكبار والعلماء الفخام أقول كلمة أمامهم تفي إن شاء الله بالغرض للمستمعين. I will try my best to say something that in front of these a'imma, big imams, I am nothing. I am nothing, but they are honoring me. So I'm trying to say something that benefit the people. Allah mentioned in Holy Quran very important story to Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdalu salatu was salam.
Allah Ta'ala say Quran Quran ayat 54.
And he gave an example of an ant, where he said, "Qalat namlatun, ya ayyuha namlu, tchulu masakinakum, la yahtimannakum Sulaiman wa junudu." One ant, an ant, small ant, between millions of ants, enter for safety, run for safety, before the army of Sayyidina Sulaiman will step on you. So they listen to one ant between them. And we, in front of such ulama, we are ants. We are nothing.
Hello.
Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdalu salatu wa salam كرمه وشرفه وعظمه الله عز وجل. Allah said to him in Holy Quran, say, يا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم كل إنما أنا بشر مثلكم يوحى إلي. Say, يا محمد, I am only a human being like you, revealed to me. This prophet can say about himself that, but we have to say Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not like us. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah gave him what he did not give anyone. He is the seals of messengers. He is the intercessor in the day of judgment for everyone. With all what Allah gave to him, he said, I am only a human being, like you, showing humbleness.
Allah
finish.
So the importance is to be humble. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam showed humbleness. Iblis showed arrogance. Allah cursed the one with arrogance and Allah praised the one with humbleness. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال من تواضع لله رفعه الله. Who will show humbleness to Allah, Allah will raise him. You cannot be arrogant. Today, unfortunately, people are arrogant. People have jealousy from each other. People, they envy each other. People are not accepting each other. They are stubborn. And Prophet ﷺ taught his Sahaba not to be stubborn, not to be arrogant. Who can declare that he knows everything? No one. Allah gave Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam all kind of knowledge, ulum al-awwalin wal-akhirin, and still Prophet say, Ya Rabbi, I know nothing in your presence.
Allah Ta'ala gave dunya ji ala kiasa. Dunya min bitarina, dunya min bilarana. Obena ala ikrayaku ahli tifuya.
Today, you have mosques like this mosque or homes like this area full of books. People wrote books. But what is the benefit of these books if you don't have wisdom? Sayyidina Ali karramallahu wajhahu wa radiyallahu anhu called Sahaba and he said to them, the whole Quran and the whole Hadith are based on one point.
Sayyidina Ali sahaba wa ali rasulina ko Quran Qurane be ani hadithu be ko rusi yore ma kele yore.
If you don't know it, you cannot understand Quran, you cannot understand Hadith.
Kuni ma alif mo yifamia kiti se ka Quran yifamia kiti se ka.
People today, they go and memorize Holy Quran, which alhamdulillah is very good. They study Quran, which is very good. They study explanation of Quran, which is very good. They study Hadith, which is very good. They study Fiqh, Sharia, is very good. But if they don't have this point, all what they have done, they wasted their time.
Mais allez fini d'orbe, nati moro, allez karanime na fatala.
Why? Because if you don't know that, how you are going to understand Holy Quran? Sahaba said to Sayyidina Ali, Ya Ali, tell us what is that in order that we can learn. And what he said, very simple, four words. He said, رأس الحكمة مخافة الله. The head of all knowledges, the head of wisdom, wisdom means all knowledges, secrets, the head of that is مخافة الله, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you don't have makhafatullah, even you memorize the whole Quran, what is going to benefit you? Nothing. If you don't have makhafatullah, you memorize the whole ahadith of Nabi. How many scholars they go up on manabir Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they speak and they don't apply on themselves because they don't have makhafatullah. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a hadith, أخوف ما أخاف على أمتي رجل عليم باللسان جهول بالقلب. I fear for my ummah one person, means one means many, that جهول عليم باللسان, he speak very eloquently, but جهول بالقلب, ignorant in the heart, means no مخافة الله in the heart. How many today you have of them? Today people, they are ulama ul ummah. That's why we have to know, like for Maulana Imam Quddus, why I love him, I respect him, I kiss his hand even, because he is sincere, he's humble, he's pious.
Allahu Akbar.
Is he has makhafatullah in his heart. Like Imam, like many of his very close friends. So when you have someone has makhafatullah in his heart, you at least that person you can speak with him because he shows you respect and humbleness. Taqwa, when someone fear Allah, has taqwa in his heart. If someone has taqwa, he doesn't need anyone, Allah will teach him. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهُ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهُ. And if he was not able to learn by himself, Allah will send someone for sure to guide that person to haqq, to follow the way of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
ni mesia alanye ni atese na yere mase ka yere kana ko alamina dochia ma kana akase ka ten chiefe chensira fe ala fira kasira.
Allah said in Holy Quran, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu ittaqullah wa kunu ma'as sadiqin. Ya o mu'min. Allahu Akbar. He didn't say O Muslim. He said O mu'min. Because mu'min is different level of Muslim. It's a very important point.
Avec moi, nous venons de faire. Amas, cela m'a au profond. Parce que, Barry, cela m'a au clé. Nous venons de faire au clé.
La taquulu amanna, balkulu aslamna. Walamma yadkhulu imanu ila kulubiku. Don't say we are mu'min. Say we are Muslim. Because yet iman did not enter in your heart. Islam, yes, entered. So what is Islam and what is Iman? Big difference. Islam, all of us, we are doing Islam. Shahadatu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Wa iqamu salah, everyone. Making prayer. Wa iqamu salah wa sawmu ramadan wa itau zakah wa sawmu ramadan wa hajjul bayt. Five pillars of Islam. Every one of Muslims has to do them. But Iman is different. Because when Jibreel asked about Islam, Prophet gave him these five pillars. So, la taqulu amanna, don't say amanna. Kulu aslamna, you are doing what the obligation of Islam you have to do. But Iman is a higher level than Islam. Iman is to believe in Allah, His prophets, messengers, angels, holy books, واليوم الآخر, the last day, and the Qadr, خيره وشره, to believe in the whatever the destiny, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it. So we believe in Allah, everyone believe. Believe in Prophet, everyone believe. Believe in holy books, everyone believe. You believe in the Day of Judgment, everyone. But do you believe in Qadr, destiny? No, means you are not surrendering yet to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's one of the main sources of Iman, is to believe in the destiny. Means whatever comes from people coming against you or speaking bad about you, say, Ya Rabbi, I'm forgiving them. To submit like a dead person, no complaint, dead person submitting. If you don't submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are not yet fulfilling the reality of Iman. Still, you need to progress. Surrender. That's why Allah said in Holy Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, ittaqullah wa kunu ma'a as-sadiqin. Means when you surrender to Allah and you submit to His will and to His qadr, at that time you have the right to be with these trustworthy people.
That's why Allah Ta'ala said for an Muminun ma, ko'omi ma yaledo, ka'i
keni tiyanfolaw ma.
Ay keni tiyanfolaw ma.
No, tiyanfolaw, who be tiyanfolaw?
Munu be tiyanfolaw ma.
By this way you are able to be with trustworthy people, because to accompany a trustworthy person is very difficult. Example. For example. To follow, to accompany. It's a trustworthy person is very difficult. Sadiq.
Sadiq.
Example in Holy Quran, Sayyidina Musa and Sayyidina Khidr alayhi salam. This one a messenger from five big prophets, and this one, there are two opinions in Islam. Scholarly opinion. One opinion says Sayyidina Khidr is prophet, and another opinion says Sayyidina Khidr is a wali. So whatever it is, Sayyidina Musa is higher. Sayyidina Khidr is not of the level of Sayyidina Musa, but he was not able to accompany him. And this is one Khidr. How many Khidr there is? Not necessary in there is one Khidr, but how many trustworthy people learning from the examples of Sayyidina al-Khidr? Allah mentioned one abd, fawajada abdan min ibadina. One from many, because abdan min ibadina, it means I showed Musa one of my servants that I have many of them, ibadina, one of them. They were not able to move along with each other. How many of these people in the ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? That was in the ummah of Sayyidina Musa. In the time of Sayyidina Musa, ummatun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not compared with ummah Sayyidina Musa. This ummah is a blessed ummah. So there is no way to compare with that. Where are these ibadina? Where are these ahlul haq, rijalul haq? Where are they? Where they are hiding themselves? This one of them.
Allahu Akbar.
So, if you are able to complete your iman, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send you a trustworthy person to guide you.
When you say that, I'm going to 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 say that, I'm going to
say that. So, that trustworthy will guide you. Don't say, I don't need a guide. If you say, I don't need a guide, I do it by myself, you are destroying the principle of Islam that every action comes with a reaction. Every reaction comes with an action, every action comes with a reaction, means cause and effect. Sunnatullah. Everything is being arranged.
هذا كلام بابرا في مالي وانا نعرف هم هذا
تقديم
طولهم من كندا
هذا ابني في المتاهل
هذا ولدك؟
ولدي
ما شاء الله
أكثر من 20 سنة هو موجود هناك
أهلا بكم. Everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in every action Allah showed cause and effect. Without cause and effect means you do something, you get something. It's dunya al-asbab. So, and if someone say, I don't need a guide, he is coming against the teaching of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allahu Akbar, wa mashallah. Why it is, if you don't do it, you are coming against the teaching of Prophet? Because Prophet did it. He asked for a dalil, for a guide, when he left from Mecca to Medina. Why? Prophet who went for Isra and Mi'raj in the second year of Islam cannot go from Mecca and Medina without a guide? He can, but he said, no, I want to show my ummah that they need a guide.
الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أقام مكة من أبي إكرام الدين. أهل الكلام الرسول
katasana waya soro gidi tabo lali tabo me ale na soro ko a bona mi ga ma ko ta medina ay mu lali kan mi be ka sura da o ko le ko dieu ko na ala tire ni ko ambe e dieu la tire ni ko mu wa bi sunde e lali ga ba ke bana na be ni ko ku ite la ite la be ce qui il pourra alors ta ka sana il pourra alors ta ka tire ça.
If we take a guide, it is the sign of humbleness. If I say, for example, if someone come ask me, you are his sheikh or he is your sheikh, what I have to say? If they ask me, Sheikh Quddus is your sheikh or you are his sheikh, what I have to say? I say, Sheikh Quddus is my sheikh. I have to respect, everyone has to respect the other. I'm not losing anything. If I say Sheikh Quddus is my sheikh, Allah will be happy with me, Prophet is happy with me, I show sign of humbleness. But you might ask people on the street, scholars in different areas, who is this one your sheikh? He said, no, this one is his own sheikh, I have my sheikh. That is arrogance. So guidance, we need guidance. There is hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in different sahih, but not in Bukhari and Muslim, that ashabi kan nujum bi-ayyihim iqtadaytum ihtadaytum. My sahaba is like stars in the dark nights. Through anyone you follow, you will be guided. So he said that you need my sahaba to guide you, as if he is directing us to choose one of these sahaba to guide us. Not to say, I don't need to be guided by him, I take from Prophet directly. No, you cannot take from Prophet directly. There is a hierarchy in Islam. نختم بآية من القرآن الكريم وفوق كل ذي علم above every knower there is another knower, above every knowledge there is another knowledge, means knowledge never ends. So don't say you know something. All what you know is not a drop of the ocean of knowledge that Prophet has in his heart. Sayyidina Musa and Sayyidina al-Khidr. Khulasa summary. Wa min Allah al-tawfiq bi hurmat al-Fatiha.
Bismillahi r-Rahman r-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Maliki yawmiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Ihdinas siratal mustaqim.
تقبل الله.
صلاة.
ما شاء الله.
بارك الله.
Where are you hiding yourself? We need you in America.
إن شاء الله موجود في نيو جيرسي أنا عايش والله.
I am. We are buying a church in New Jersey now.
إن شاء الله.